Are you living a life that you can really be proud of? When your grandchildren ask you what you did with your life, what are you going to tell them? How are you going to feel when you tell them that you spent 40 years of your life doing accounting for a company that makes pencils and spending your nights and weekends watching Seinfeld reruns and college football? If that's you, if that's the path you're on, I'm not trying to shame you. I'm trying to help you find a better way. The truth is, most people throw away their dreams and live lives of mediocrity, and then they bury their embarrassment under mountains of antidepressants and cheap entertainment. Being successful at just about anything is hard. It's uncomfortable, it takes work, it takes effort, and it takes risk. So rather than man up and live a life they can be proud of, most people come up with a laundry list of excuses to make themselves feel better for never even trying to fulfill their God-given purpose in life. In this video, I'm going to go over 9 of the most common excuses and why they don't actually make any sense. So if you want to cling to a bunch of excuses and never do anything worthwhile with your life, then I suggest you stop watching this video. It will only make you more depressed. Excuse number one, I don't have the right personality. A lot of people say things like, oh, I'm just not the business type, or I'm too introverted, as if that somehow disqualifies them from success. The truth is, personality is something that you develop over the course of your life. If your personality isn't working for you to achieve your God-given purpose in life, then it is your responsibility to change your personality. If you're too shy or too ADD or too much of a perfectionist or whatever it is, I guarantee you that with enough effort that you can change that and your life will be much better as a result. And for that matter, you can succeed even with some personality flaws. I mean, I'm sure you could find a million examples of people who are shy or who were ADD and found amazing success. So either change it or work around it. Either one is totally possible. Excuse number two, I don't know how to do X. Let me give you a little history lesson. Back in the days of Moses, when somebody wanted to communicate something with other people in the future, they would carve letters into stone tablets. And then other people could come along later and look at the stone tablets and read the writing and learn whatever it was that the writer wanted to communicate to them. So if you're lucky enough to be alive sometime after the year 3000 BC, then you can go find some stone tablets that tell you how to do whatever it is that you don't know how to do. Or if you want to be all fancy and modern, you could read a book, or watch a video, or take an online course. Seriously, this is the most ridiculous excuse, because whatever you don't know how to do, you can go learn. Excuse number three, I didn't go to college. Some people seem to think that just because they didn't get a certificate of mediocrity from some institute of higher miseducation means that they are doomed to spend the rest of their lives cooking French fries. But the truth is that a college degree is an expensive waste of time and money that they can do without. Actually, people with certificates of mediocrity are at a disadvantage in a lot of ways. Not just the obvious wasting 4+ years and taking on a mountain of debt, but also people with college degrees tend to get stuck in middle-class jobs, which are just as unfulfilling, but they pay more than poor people jobs, so most middle-class people are scared to death to ditch their soul-destroying corporate desk jobs because that means giving up their above-average salaries. So if you didn't go to college, that means that you've got more time, less debt, and less to lose. Don't act like it's holding you back, because it's not. You're more likely to do something meaningful with your life if you didn't get sucked into the college trap. By the way, if you're enjoying this video, please hit the thumbs up, because it makes the YouTube algorithm like me better. And hit the subscribe button, hit the little bell icon beside the subscribe button so you don't miss anything. And share this video with somebody who needs to hear it. There's no excuse not to. Okay, excuse number four. I live in the wrong country. Okay, this one I have a little bit of sympathy for, but I still think it's a bad excuse. If you're living in a poor country and there's not a lot of money being thrown around, and maybe some internet services and some payment processors don't serve your country, that can look like a big disadvantage. But that just means you have to be a little more creative, and you're probably missing some things that could work in your favor. For example, in my travels, I've noticed that starting a business in a poorer country is often a lot easier than starting a business in a richer country, as long as you stay under the government radar. Here in Brazil, for example, anybody can buy a table and a few bottles of liquor and a few mixers and start selling cocktails on the beach. It's a super easy way to make some money on your own schedule and without paying taxes, and you get to hang out on the beach. Not bad. If you try doing that in the United States, you go to jail. You need to get a liquor license and a street vendor license, and you have to get inspected by the FDA 4 times a year. Basically, you need the government's permission to do anything. That whole land of the free thing kind of ended a long time ago. Anyway, there's a lot of opportunities because of less regulation, and I've also noticed that the marketing is not as good in poorer countries. So that leaves a ton of opportunities for you to find businesses whose marketing is basically non-existent and provide it for them, and they'll pay you a nice part of the profit because you are the one bringing in the money. So even if you live in a poor country, there's still plenty of opportunities for you to start a business and make money if you're observant, if you look around for what the needs are, and then maybe you could make some money and move to a richer country, or you could stay and use your new money and influence to make your own country better. Excuse number five, I'm not smart enough, I'm not handsome enough, I'm not tall enough, my voice isn't deep enough. Right? People love to use their physical attributes or their genetics as an excuse to never do anything. And maybe that excuse makes sense if your dream is to be a brain surgeon or a basketball player or a runway model and you need to go find a new dream, but for everybody else it's a dumb excuse. If you're not smart enough, as in you don't know enough to be successful, go read some books, right? We've been over that one. And if you're short and ugly, just go look at all the other ugly short people who have had amazing success. It just doesn't matter very much anymore. I mean, half of the people that are making millions are just sitting behind a computer screen all day anyway. Nobody ever really has to see what you look like. Actually, it can be an advantage if you cut the self-pity and actually start trying. If you're short and ugly and you got F's in school, then you could be really inspirational to other people because nobody is going to accuse you of being successful just because you got lucky in the genetic lottery. Being relatable is a huge asset. Stop using it as an excuse and start using it as an advantage. Excuse number six. Well, I might fail and embarrass myself. If you use this as an excuse, I have news for you. You will fail and you will embarrass yourself. Probably a lot of times. But if you can swallow your pride and keep failing and keep embarrassing yourself, eventually you'll learn what works and what doesn't, and you can use it to be successful. And you'll succeed in whatever you're trying to do. I remember after I quit my job and started my own business and telling everybody how much money I was gonna make, and my family asked me, did I make any money yet? And I said, $14. Yeah, it was embarrassing. But it's just pride, which isn't serving you anyway. If you can get rid of your pride, like I talk about in this video, you will be more powerful than you ever dreamed possible. Excuse number seven, I don't have money. Yes, for most things in life, you need some money to get started. So if you don't have any money, quit complaining, quit spending 4 hours a day playing Call of Duty, and go make some money. Get a job flipping burgers or washing toilets, or go sell cocktails on the beach, or go find a business that you can do without any upfront investment, like I show you how to do in this video. Find some way to make some money so you can invest in what you ultimately want to be doing. Actually, if you stop making stupid excuses, then being broke can actually help you on your path to becoming rich, as I describe in this video. Excuse number eight, I don't have any time. Or, I have too many responsibilities. You have a job, a wife, kids, a dog, sick grandmother, I get it. No, I don't want you to abandon the people who depend on you. But do you really not have any time that you could spare? How much time do you spend watching TV? Oh, but I have to watch Game of Thrones. Or playing video games. Or scrolling mindlessly through Facebook. Be honest with yourself and you'll realize you have time. You just have to make some sacrifices. You also probably have time where you're doing something, but you're doing some mindless activity, so you're not utilizing it fully. So if you have to commute to work, listen to an audiobook. Have to wait at the DMV? Read something. Have to do laundry or wash the dishes? Listen to an online course on your phone while you're doing it. If you start valuing your time for what it's really worth when you're working towards your true purpose, you start to find bits of free and misused time all over the place. Excuse number nine, oh, I just don't care about money. Okay, then what do you care about? You care about freedom, having new experiences, your family, your country, the starving kids in Africa? Well, guess what? All of those could benefit from you having more money. People think they're being righteous when they say that they don't care about money, but what they're really saying is they don't care enough to put the effort to make their own lives better or to make anybody else's lives better either. Chasing your dreams isn't about money. If you make a positive impact in the world, you'll make a lot of money doing it, and then you can use that money to make even more positive impact in the world. That's why God gave you life, not so you can waste it away sitting in some dusty cubicle, fixing bugs in some giant corporation's compliance database for some frantic middle manager. Those are the most common excuses I hear for people to live a life of mediocrity. Do you have another excuse? Let me know in the comments and maybe I'll berate you in a future video. And if you're ready to dump your excuses and actually be useful to the world, you might like this video all about 5 high income skills that you can teach yourself in just 2 weeks. And of course, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. You have no excuse.